creating a transformation. So I'm going to show you how to do this transformation that's given. It says x comma y is mapped to x plus 2 comma y minus 3. So that means that every point is going to be mapped to a new point according to that rule. So in creating a transformation, what we do is we use the vertices or the corners and we move those. And then we just assume, and correctly so, that all the points in between get moved also. So let's show you how that works. Okay, here we have 0, 0. And if we put 0, 0 goes to 0 plus 2, comma 0 minus 3, we're going to get 0, 0 goes to 2, comma negative 3. So there's 2 and then negative 3 is right here. Okay, the next point, let's use this one. It's going to be 3, 0. 3, 0 goes to 3 plus 2, comma 0 minus 3. So that's going to go to 5, comma negative 3. So over 5 and then down 3 puts us right here. Okay, and this third vertex up here, is it 0, 2? So 0, 2 is going to go to 0 plus 2, and then 2 minus 3. So that's going to go to 2 comma negative 1. 2 negative 1 is right here. Okay, so now we have three vertices, those points that move. The thing is, each pair of vertices is connected by a segment, and each segment contains an infinite number of points. Okay, so what I just did here is I translated all the points in between these vertices onto the new triangle, which is the image. So for example, 1, 0 right here, that got translated down here to 3, negative 3. And you can say 2, 0 got translated to 4, negative 3. And you pick any point on any of these segments, it got mapped to a corresponding point on the image. So that's how you create a transformation. You find the vertices, you translate those points, and then you translate the segments that connect them.